Greetings, friends! We are here in Indiana visiting some fellow homesteaders, and we look forward to seeing their greenhouse and the different things that they are doing here and sharing it with you guys, but you're just gonna have to stay tuned for that. Well, over the past several years that we have been homesteaders, we have seen an increase in people being interested in getting back to the way of life that people used to live back in the day, that our ancestors used to live, and growing things and providing for themselves and
raising
not
animals.
Relying on the grocery stores and other just all the technological things to take care of us, that they were hands-on participating in a way of life that produced for them and for their families. Well, the past year especially, I have seen people really being pricked in their minds and hearts to get back to this lifestyle. A lifestyle that is more sustainable.
For
a
sure.
Lifestyle that really produces. It's the lifestyle of producing and not just consuming. And it's been refreshing to see that, because many people are alarmed at all the things that are going on in our world and seeing how fragile our food system is. And many people decided to just out of the blue start getting things like chickens and then figuring out that, hey, I don't know what to do with these chickens. I don't know how to raise them. I know that I should be doing this because I want to have fresh eggs and get into this homesteading thing, but I have no idea what I am doing. Well, we made our fair share of mistakes when we started our homestead, and I don't see any of them as regrets, because I learned a lot of lessons from them, from those mistakes. However, knowing what I know now and being around all the different people we've had the opportunity to be around, if I was to go back to when we first started our homestead, having all this experience in my mind now, and start all over again, there would be some things that I would do differently. Well, one of the things that we have greatly benefited from over the past 2 years or so is going around visiting other homesteaders and other farms and seeing how they do things. We really benefited from seeing places like Baker Creek and Polyface Farm. We've learned a lot from these people and seeing how they have their systems. And let me tell you, having that information and being able to learn from experienced people is greatly beneficial and can really save you a lot of time, a lot of money, and hopefully avoid a lot of mistakes by tapping in to their experience.
For sure.
And I know that you watching, you can't go and visit all the different places that we have been able to see, nor learn directly from people like Joel, from specifically and directly from Joel as your personal mentor in person. But you know what? The good news is Joel is offering a course, a series, and he's also provided 3 free videos that you can check in now as part of that course. Check it out. Because Joel discusses things in this course that you really don't see anywhere else. Whether it be, yes, you can learn a lot of the how-to parts of homesteading from YouTube videos or conferences or magazine articles, but there's a lot of the grittier, more important aspects and not as attractive aspects of homesteading that are really, really important. Things like how to pick out the land that you're going to set your homestead on. Whether you should buy or rent the land.
How close to town you should be so you can make sure whatever you're producing is marketable. I mean, all these different things Joel covers in this course that he's made.
And I wish that this course would have been available when we started homesteading, because it would have saved us thousands of hours of time and energy and money as well. And I think that starting off with a course like this would be really, really beneficial. I took a course from Curtis Stone about market gardening early on in our homesteading journey, and it saved
really
me a lot of years of having to figure out what crops to grow, when to grow them, and where to sell them, how to sell them. And having just a full course just about homesteading is absolutely amazing. And we've had the opportunity to see some of these videos. Joel also covers a number of things like how to do the design of the landscape. And to assess your landscape, to see what you're able to do on that land is extremely valuable information.
and talking about water, and there's just so much information right there, you know, over 50 years of information that they have, that they've compiled into this course, and it's beautifully shot. It's just like you're right there with Joel sitting around talking with him, and it's very applicable things that you can do on how to cut cost, how to raise your animals, I guess I don't want to say on the cheap, but so it's really great for someone starting out and for making your homestead more efficient.
And one of the things that I really enjoyed about our visit when we went to Polyface was seeing Joel's ponds and his water system. But in this video series, he actually shows you how to do a system just like his on whatever property you may decide to start your homestead and start a pond.
And this course is the perfect opportunity to learn from someone that has been there, done that, made the mistakes, has refined it down, and has a very successful, you know, farm homestead business. And he wants to relay all this information to you to make you successful on your homestead.
And we encourage you guys to check out the 3 free videos from Joel. We'll provide the link in the show notes below. And consider taking part of the full course, because there will be there's so much information there that will really help you guys in your homesteading journey. Whether you're considering getting started, or whether you just got started, or whether you've been homesteading for years like we have, you can benefit from it. So check it out.
Oh, and I do want to say, make sure you go and click through the link and sign up, because there's only a limited amount of time that you can sign up for this course, and we don't want you to miss it.
Don't miss out.